वेलकम ऑल टू डे स्टॉप ब्रेकिंग न्यूज विद गीतांजलि फ्रॉम बायन टाइम्स। आंध्र प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट कॉन्स्टिट्यूट्स एएमआरडीए टू रिप्लेस एपीसीआरडीए। द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ आंध्र प्रदेश हैज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड अमरावती मेट्रोपॉलिटन रीजन डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी एएमआरडीए टू रिप्लेस द आंध्र प्रदेश कैपिटल रीजन डेवलपमेंट अथॉरिटी एपीसीआरडीए। एन ऑर्डर रिगार्डिंग द सेम वॉज इशूड लेट नाइट। एज पर द गैजेट नोटिफिकेशन, the areas within the jurisdiction of Andhra Pradesh Capital Region under the Principal Act, APCRDA Act 2014, Act 11 of 2014, shall be deemed to be area of the Amravati Metropolitan Region Development Authority, which shall be notified by the government on cessation of APCRDA. AMRDA will have Secretary Municipal Administration and Urban Development Department as Deputy Chairperson. Metropolitan Commissioner AMRDA will be Member Convener, Principal Secretary, Finance, Collectors of Krishna and Guntur Districts, Director of the Town and Country Planning, Deputy Transport Commissioner of Guntur District, Superintendent Engineers R&B of Guntur and Krishna Districts, Superintendent Engineer APTRAN SCO of Vijayawada, Superintendent Engineer APCPDCL of Vijayawada will be members. Andhra Pradesh government to sign MOU with Indian School of Business on August 5. The state government is all set to enter into an agreement with Hyderabad-based Indian School of Business ISB on August 5. A decision to this effect was taken during a video conference convened by Industries and Commerce Minister Mekapati Gautam Reddy with the representatives of the ISB, stating that Andhra Pradesh will be the first state in India to exchange an Memorandum of Understanding MOU with the ISB. The minister exuded confidence that the pact would come in handy to resolve crucial issues in administration. Besides focusing on attracting investments, the three-year MOU with the ISB will lay emphasis on getting multinational companies to the state to generate employment. Over 50% cops who tested COVID positive have recovered and joined Andhra Pradesh DGP, stating that the recovery rate of COVID-19 cases in the police department is satisfactory. Director General of Police DGP T. Gautam Savang has said that more than 50% of them have recovered and resumed duties. While speaking to police officials in a special online workshop organized in collaboration with Apollo Hospitals, the top cop explained the safety measures and treatment of COVID-19. Savang praised the police personnel for their selfless work in containing the deadly virus and reminded the services and sacrifices of frontline warriors in the line of duty. He said that more than 3,600 police personnel across the state were infected with coronavirus so far. With the lockdown restrictions lifted in June, people started their normal activity, which exposed us police to the virus. While the total cases is just less than 50, the number increased suddenly to a shocking 3,600 after the relaxation in lockdown, Savang pointed out. COVID-19, Hyderabad International Airport receives mass fever screening system. The Hyderabad International Airport on Sunday said it has received a UNICEF-funded mass fever screening system from the central government, which will help enhance the efficiency of the screening process as part of its fight against COVID-19. The new thermal scanner, which will be used by the airport health officials, is a ceiling-mounted mass fever screening system, a release from GMR Hyderabad International Airport Limited, GHIAL, the company that operates the city airport, said. This system is capable of scanning, detecting and tracking febrile persons with elevated skin temperature. The system automatically adjusts and adapts to the surrounding ambient temperature without any human intervention, it said. With its intuitive user interface and dual displays, day camera plus infrared, it provides easy identification of passengers with elevated temperatures while simplifying operations and minimizing handling, it said. Amravati development details to be revealed soon, Andhra Pradesh Minister Pocha Satyanarayana. With the decks getting cleared for relocation of executive capital to Visakhapatnam, the issue of how the state government would use the existing infrastructure, for which about rupees 9,000 crore has been spent in the past 5 years, still remains a question, while clarity on which stalled projects would be resumed and how they would be used is yet to be given by the government, Municipal Administration and Urban Development Minister Bocha Satyanarayana told. Telangana government panel to crack the whip on private hospitals fleecing COVID-19 patients. Health Minister Yettala Rajender ordered a vigilance committee to investigate the complaints about private hospitals charging exorbitantly for COVID-19 treatment. Although the government has fixed prices for COVID-19 treatment at private hospitals, many are not following the orders. It is not appropriate to burden the people in the name of medicines, PPE kits, ICU charges, and high salaries for staff. We have conducted an extensive review of the complaints, the minister, who noted the rising number of such complaints, said. He was outraged that the hospitals have forgotten their responsibility of providing medical care and are behaving without a humanitarian perspective for profit. At this crucial point, private hospitals were asked to do their part in saving people's lives without thinking of business. It is incorrect to cash in on people's fears. We have received complaints that artificial shortage of beds has been created by private hospitals, due to which they are charging lakhs from patients and not admitting them without advance payments. Even asymptomatic people are being admitted and charged similarly, Yettala said. TN Governor Banwarilal Purohit test positive for COVID-19, is asymptomatic and stable. Tamil Nadu Governor Banwarilal Purohit test positive for COVID-19 in Chennai. He is asymptomatic and clinically stable, according to a statement issued by the hospital. Earlier on Sunday, Governor Banwarilal Purohit visited a private hospital. This comes in the wake of 84 people in Rajbhavan testing positive for COVID-19 last week. The governor was in home quarantine for the past few days. Governor Banwarilal Purohit is 81 years old and he said not have come in contact with any of those who were infected by COVID-19 in Rajbhavan. Telangana only agenda, IT Minister K.T. Rama Rao predicts so-sal life for TRS. The Telangana Rashtra Samiti will live on for 100 more years as the party had its moorings in a strong muhurtam fixed by Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao, said TRS Working President K.T. Rama Rao while addressing a gathering at Telangana Bhavan. He was speaking after handing over a cheque for Rs 16.11 crore to the United India Insurance Company towards the premium for year 2020-21. This insurance cover would protect close to 60 lakh TRS members across the state. He said so far, the TRS has paid Rs 47,65,93,880 towards the premium amount. He hinted that TRS President and Chief Minister was thinking of announcing some innovative programs for party workers. Rama Rao said that TRS had emerged a strong political force in the country. The national parties may have their presence in other states and might have 100 agendas, but TRS has only one agenda, Telangana, he said, while describing TRS as Tirukuleni Rajakiya Sakti. Over 20 lakh COVID-19 tests done in Andhra Pradesh after testing of more than 60,000 samples. Andhra Pradesh has conducted more than 20 lakh tests for coronavirus, the fourth highest in the country after Tamil Nadu, Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra. The state reached this milestone after testing 60,797 samples in the 24 hours. The total number of samples tested in the state stands at 20,12,573. For the first time in recent weeks, more recoveries than new cases were reported in the day. While 12,750 COVID-19 patients recovered and were discharged between Friday and Saturday, 9,276 people were found to be infected. In the same period, 58 people lost their lives to the virus. The state presently has 72,188 known active cases, as 150,209 people have tested positive for coronavirus and 76,614 of them recovered and 1,407 died. The mortality rate stands at 0.94% less than the national average of 2.15%. No new cases have been recorded among people arriving from other states or countries in the past couple of weeks, and all 2,461 people who reached Andhra Pradesh from other states and 434 from abroad who tested positive have recovered. Women's safety. Andhra Pradesh CM Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy to launch E-Raksha Bandhan. Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy will be launching E-Raksha Bandhan, a month-long awareness program on the safety of women and children in cyberspace on Monday. With the collaboration of Cyber Peace Foundation, the program will be conducted jointly by the state police and CID to bring awareness among the public, especially women, youth and children, through webinars and Andhra Pradesh CID's official YouTube channel. The participants will be explained different types of cyber crimes and tackling techniques and alarm-raising methods. To mark Raksha Bandhan, we will hold the awareness program. Cyber crime experts from various parts of the country will speak on cyber crimes, said additional DGP CID PV Sunil Kumar said in a release. He requested the people and students to watch the events live on Andhra Pradesh CID's YouTube channel. With this, we conclude with our today's news headlines. For more such latest news and updates, like, share and subscribe BYN Times.